adrenaline of it, a little bit of danger is, it gives you that adrenaline rush.
Go ahead and grab me a line. Start heading out to floor two.
That's just how it goes. You hope for a little bit of a break, but it you don't get it. Not with like two toddlers running around, you know. And they're the priority, you know. My needs when I come home are kind of put on the back burner, and that's okay.
Sometimes it feels like you're not totally, but you feel like you're maybe a single parent just for that day. And there's a lot of trying to work that out together because, you know, one of us doesn't stay at home. So one of us is not here all the time. So one day will be a dad day. The next day will be a mom day.
Really was looking at that path, and so I encouraged her that, I mean, she can do anything. You put your mind to it, and she could do it. And she's definitely has the strength and the smartness to do anything she wants. Firefighting's not just strength. It's learning the techniques of it. And you don't have to be the biggest person or the strongest person, or strongest guy or strongest girl. I think it proves that they've earned their position on this fire truck and the medic units like everybody else. We see citizens in our community in a very intimate setting, and I would say females bring a higher level of emotional intelligence in those interactions, and we can all learn from that.
How heavy is this, by the way?
It's always in the back of my mind of, you know, today absolutely could be the day that we run into something we've never seen before and we're put in an unsafe situation. So, and as the officer, I'm more aware of that role of I kind of have to step back and make sure that everybody else is safe.
Oh, we're gonna call.
Oh.
So we're getting a call right now, Adam.
Okay.
So you guys are going to be coming with us. I'm going to have you sit in the middle, and then Marcus, you're going to sit in the far seat. Just make sure you have your seatbelts on.
I go inside.
Marcus,
go ahead and jump.
Bravo 2.
Okay. Going on a vehicle fire, 224th and Meridian. Those are both pretty main roads for us. So we're gearing up, getting ready, and then we'll head out and go see what happens.
I really didn't even know women could be a firefighter. I was coaching CrossFit part-time, and a lot of the members there were firefighters, and they all loved what they did, and they are kind of what put, you know, the idea in my head that maybe it was something I would like to do.
I'd come to work back in the day with, like, I'd actually combed my hair or put makeup on, and they're like, well, you know, why are you wearing makeup? Are you looking for a man? You need to learn when to give it back and when to just walk away. Some men will never learn.
We'll do extra feeding. Did it get a little? Eh. Water.
I'm not 6'6". I don't have big old shoulder pads for, you know, muscles or anything. It's not just brute strength, it's mechanics. It's using all those muscles to get it done. I might not look as cool as the guys, but, you know, I still get it done.
And then use the handles. Yep. So you're gonna pull it out, turn, place it on your shoulder.
Komplizierter, als es ausschaut, ehrlich gesagt. Uff, okay. So viele Dinge, die man beachten muss.
Yep. You're doing so good! Nice! Woo! Nice job!
Es ist einfach sehr beeindruckend, was diese Frauen hier täglich leisten.
Every day there's some type of danger that we encounter, whether it's a motor vehicle accident, we're in the middle of the road. We have to watch our backs for other vehicles that aren't paying attention. Like I said, violent people, you know, people under the influence of drugs and alcohol are very unpredictable. And just, you know, scene safety as far as if we're at a burning building, those houses go up very quickly.
No hazard canceling coming. No hazard canceling coming in 37.
And he said, where's the 6-foot men? Because last time, I guess the bigger guys came.